I used to think ghosts didn't exist.
A wise assumption on your part, given the rarity of the phenomenon and the shameless hucksters who claim to commune with the departed.
But some folks can do it. Commune with the departed.
Well, I don't know any confirmed mediums, but I was once a second in a duel against a charlatan who claimed she could put my friend in contact with his dead father.
Could she do it?
Well, she did kill my friend in the duel, so I'd say it's all a matter of perspective.
Interesting. Hey guys, it's been a hot minute, huh? Welcome back to Lamplighters League. It's been like 3 weeks since I've played, and I just actually went ahead and watched like the second half of the ending of the last episode of my own computer, like trying to figure out what's going on with it. So sorry about the lapse. I have been wanting to play this for a long time. I just can never get to it. At the moment, I'm looking at upgrading some skills with Celestine. I feel like I use her. I'm probably going to use her in every single fight. She's just too good. And this Umbral Edge is pretty interesting for 4 skill points, but I'd love to get this. Increased damage, higher crit chances, all around. But I can't give her this until we have Seric Steel. I need to get one of those. And so I'm going to grab that because it's a good passive. But we are going to go to the world map. And we're not going to do these extra missions. I think I'm going to stick to the original plan that I had, which was to just go for it and just to get in there and do Nicastro's heist here. This is the Cold Epiphany. The phenomena aren't that big of a deal. I think we can push through these ones. I might regret that because honestly, I don't think I've ever actually faced a ton of tide spawn before. So we'll see if that's a big deal. But Seric Steel is one of the rewards for this mission, and I want to get that to get the better weapons so we can go after Marteau, right? So we're gonna get some skill points here, we're gonna get some aether here, not a big deal. But the biggest thing is this is a heist. It's gonna be a long mission. We're gonna infiltrate House Nicastro, secret pump house, and recover a sample of abyssal nectar. So squad for this, I think this is the team. I see no reason to change it. It's been working pretty well. As far as items to bring, we do have a heal there. I think maybe we could outfit Ingrid with her own heal as well, just to bring one other med kit too. Make sure we have them. Celestine has a med kit. I think I might get her to bring a... is there anything that has to do with stress here? Stress flask. This inflicts stress, which could be useful, but I want the stress remedy. That's what I want. So we're going to get her a stress remedy just in case. And I think that's probably pretty good. We'll let Eddie kind of be a pack rat here and let him be the mule that's going to go ahead and grab things. We have a spare slot on everybody, so at least we can pick up something with everybody. And we're fully equipped with these guys already, so I say we just get to it. Start the mission, a Cold Epiphany, the Nicastro heist. I don't know, like, we're going to do a really difficult mission after kind of being a little rusty at the game. I hope I don't make any big mistakes. The sea is troubled tonight, almost as if it knows our plans. As I write, my agents fly to the place House Nicastro calls its pump house. There, they will locate a set of extraction tools on site and use them to steal a sample of abyssal nectar. And all the while, they will be within one of the cult's holiest sites. A trial of both the body and the mind. Let the nectar heist begin.
This is it. House Nicastro's nectar facility. The informant called it the pump house.
We know our purpose. First, to retrieve the extraction tools from the ship at the dock.
All right, so, oh boy, we're just gonna get right into it here. Let's really quick see if we have any extras around here. Looks like we got some aether right away. It's pretty good. I don't know if there was anything behind us. I didn't check, so I probably should do that too. We'll just go around really quick. Let's see if we got anything back here. I love the storm. That's pretty cool. I don't think we've had a map yet where there was like actively lightning and like and thunder and all that. Like, I don't think we've actually had that on a mission yet. So it's kind of cool. I mean, I might be wrong. Like I said, it's been a hot minute, so I haven't really, I don't really have everything as fresh in my mind as I should today, but we'll see. I'm sitting down all day. It's a Tuesday. I'm sitting down all day today with my daughter in daycare. Baldur's Gate's been wrapped up. I don't have to stream today. I'm just going to play this game all day. A splash in the water and a stream of bubbles in the dim light in the shallows. So hopefully, like, even if I'm rusty today, I'll be good in the next one.
And what do we have here?
Because I'll be doing it in a couple hours. All right, so more Aether there. Seems like we pretty much got everything already at the front of this place. And in order to proceed, we're going to have to go through the door. Yeah, so no items to pick up to start the mission. There's a ladder here. I'm wondering if I can climb it. No? Not going to let me climb that ladder. Oh, that's lame. I wanted to get up there, get up high. All right, I can hear the sentinel around you. Like, somebody can really definitely see us in here. So we're going to open this door. We're going to be careful. Yeah, somebody can scan. Oh, oh, what's this? Oh, oh, okay. Okay. So he's right up close, huh? Let's get everybody to stand outside for a second.
Remain here.
And we'll get our sneak to... And I'm already hitting Baldur's Gate's commands to sneak and everything. Yeah, all right. So we're going to keep her sneaky. And I think these guys, right, we're going to have to get around with Ingrid to get those guys. As far as sneaking around this thing, though, man, I got to learn its patrol pattern if I want to have any hope at that. That's going to be a tricky one. Let's put you here. I think you're going to be safe there as far as whether the enemy can see you or not. I'm not sure if there is a pattern to his patrol, but there are two of them. So we got this one over here, which we can't see anymore. It's behind cover. And then there's one over here too. So we might have to just deal with these guys without any extra takedowns because these guys are immune to takedown. All right. So I think that we're just going to plan on that being a thing. We're going to say Alexandrite. Well, I mean, shit, he's like right there, right? Maybe we should get lead with Ingrid. I think I'm going to lead with Ingrid here. All right, now we can see their visual, their line of sight. At least we've got that. Okay, there's actually three of them. Oh, boy. All right, well, we should probably just get this party started, right? It's not going to like, it's not like it's going to get much easier. So I think we're all right here. We're bundled up in this area. And we can throw one of these over at this guy. I'm not sure he'll go for it, but we're going to try. Oh, that didn't happen. Never mind. He's walking away now. Maybe
need
I
a second.
Maybe I can get to him. Throw this. I want to get back there and get that guy. Maybe I can actually... I can draw them in, actually. Why don't we do that? Let's draw them in. They're right here. He can't be hit. He'll have somebody else go and investigate that for him. This dude over here, I really want to just... Yeah, him right there. Throw that on top of him. Go.
Easy as pie.
All right, that'll draw their attention that direction. And then we should now be able to get Alexandrite in a better position. Over here is fine. Ingrid, I need to get you more forward. Right here. And then, of course, we're immune to takedowns here, so he's going to see us. And then we're just going to strike right here. All right. Here we go. So I guess it is just the four of them. I thought there was one extra one. All right. So first thing to do here, I think with Ingrid, we can strike, but it's not going to do enough damage. I was kind of hoping to go over and get one of these guys, but I guess we can't get there. Not going to let me get to that guy, which is interesting. All right. So Celestine, why don't we start things off by taking control of our warg friend here.
Hush. Forget your fears for now.
So he's going to be on our team. Eddie is going to move back in. And he's going to kind of be exposed. That's no good. Looks like I can get him here, but he won't be able to attack. It's too far away. So unfortunately, he's just too far away to be useful. Actually, it looks like I got a shot right here. It is going to give me the shot right here. So we can go ahead and hit him twice. I think that's probably the best to do here. Bop, bop. Going to knock him down. Nice crit. Alexandrite, we need to move you over. Let's get you to here. It's a fair spot. And we'll take the arcane. Let's just shoot this target. Like, If we can take him off the board quicker, I'm all right for it.
A worthy performance.
All right, Ingrid, I want you to... tell you what, why don't we strike our friend right here? Confirm that. And then I'm going to build an evade here.
Come on.
So when he shoots, right? And then Celestine, I think maybe we'll just... I'll hold off on the gambit. It's fine. We have a rogue as well. And it's actually only a one-turn cooldown on this ability, which is very interesting.
Watch. The hand is quicker than the eye.
That's cool. We haven't used that skill with her yet, because I think we just got it. Transmutative Tempering. Hey, our friend didn't really do anything, but he drew our Overwatch, and then the evade kicks in. Perfect. All right. So next up, let's take Ghostfire, maybe in the back over here.
Let there be light.
He's going to get burned for a bit. And then we'll just take the Arcane Blast on this dude here, 40%.
That's not how I pictured it.
It's a miss, but fine. It's whatever. He's a little pissed. And he's not... Oh, I don't think he's on our team anymore. Sus. All right, we can go ahead with the curse since it's kind of...
Dread.
It's not free, but we can hit him with a curse. And then maybe we'll throw the Whispering Knife here for 90%. There we go. I think Ingrid can wrap this up now pretty easily. So we'll go ahead and take the strike on this target there. That's one. Whop. Refund. Extra stress for everybody. And I want to get... I think one more hit. I guess not him. I was hoping to recharge. Yeah, I was kind of hoping to recharge her ability here, but that's not going to happen right now. We could take the Fallen there. I'd rather just walk up to him, though, you know? Just hit him in the face right here.
I regret that it came to this.
Bang, bang, bang. And then one more hit to the face right here where you are.
That was your last chance.
And then he's dead. All right. And then all that's left is this guy. And we can just go in. And I think we'll try the stick and move here. No, we don't even need to. He's going to die. Just hit him. Done.
And on we go.
All right. We're not going to get a refresh on Celestine's skills this round. But
this way.
So far, though, I think that went quite well. Are there any... special things for us to find in this room? Strange liquors. A dark, glossy liquid drips from the still's tap, filling the air with the odor of decomposing seaweed. Man, this DeCastro really. Ugh.
Better that I hold on to this.
A balm of protection, written in a spindly hand with mottled purple ink. In its wisdom, the priesthood has collected the musk of the Slayers of the Deep and made a balm of it and provided it for our use. Thus, it is that we, his children, mark ourselves as servants and not as prey. Duly anointed, you may walk among his abyssal angels in safety and without fear. Look north, past Longfin Row, and you will find it, the sanctum where the musk is kept. Follow the smell of the sea. That's what we're doing. We're following our nose. But first, we'll open up this door into this area. Let's see if there's anything cool in here first. And we've got an item in here.
A lost thing, now found.
Some ether. Actually, I haven't found any items yet. Not specifically items, anyway. All right, so we could open the big doors, or we can go through that small door. I don't know if there's really much of a difference there. Maybe I'll just open it up anyway. Here you go. Just to say we did it. All right, on this side, there is a whole bunch of stuff going on over here. Yeah, uh-huh. I think that's our destination right over there, I think. There's also the optional objective, which is that direction, which we're going to do that. But Eddie can open this door, I think, with his lockpicking skill.
Look alive, people.
So if we want to go that way right now, we can, but... I say we go and obtain the Deep Slayer Musk first, because I like optional objectives. I like doing those. We'll open up this really quick and see if there's anything inside. This is more lore. The Codex Elatmus. There we go. I got it. Eventually. Volume 2. On Tidespawn, the fruit of metamorphosis. Metamorphosis. Is it metamorphosis or metamorphosis? How do you say it? Let me know in the comments. The exalted soldiers of our devouring king. Lithe, loping bipeds. Maybe lithe, maybe lithe. I don't actually know that word. Loping bipeds that combine the best aspects of man and eel. Tightly packed muscles on a powerful frame. Two sets of powerful jaws. All right, it's a two-headed beast, fine. And the will to put those gifts to use. Treat the Tidespawn with due reverence, O children of Sabarsud. For they are no more beasts, or no mere beasts. They are our exalted elders, beloved of the Pelagic Maw. And in the wake of his resurrection, they will inherit the drowned earth. Okay, blah, 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 blah. You guys are just... What a bunch of zealots, man. I tell you what. The more passionate they speak, the more lost they are. All right, let's go in here. Oh, another key. Eddie, can you do it? No? This one requires a key. I can't actually pick that one. All right, well, we'll find it. Wherever this key is, we're going to go get it. A whole bunch of lore here. Can I see it through the window? Excellent. Alatmus Volume 4. On the Stalkers of the Deep, the great and glorious angels of our devouring king. In form, they are octopi. Great snarls of tooth and tendril, imbued with the wisdom of the deep. The servants of our abyssal lord protect the membrane between worlds, the cord of convergence, which is sometimes known as Morrow Deep. Take care when petitioning such beings, O children of Sabarsud, for they are death incarnate, and their thirst cannot be slaked. All right. So maybe it's a bad thing that this mission has a prominent presence of them. You know, maybe it's going to be a bad thing. Volume 3. On the Childs of the Deep, the court heralds of our devouring king. Though small in size, these beloved children tower in their eminence. For they are the chorus that intones the... you know what? I don't care. I don't care. You're just going to... Yes, yes. You idolize the tentacle people. I understand.
All right. I can't seem to catch my breath.
What is this? What is this? Oh. Well, they're in there. Whoever they are. Ah, yeah, they're in there. Okay. What is that? Let me go turn-based. Is R, right? Okay, this is the Child of the Deep. An undersea creature sealed tightly inside a softly thrumming glass jar. Its frenzied whispers inflict stress on all believers within earshot. So, with an earshot, is that what this is? This is the frenzied whispers right here. Okay, so the red area is frenzied whispers, a curious beckoning, a grim repulsion. Agents within earshot of frenzied whisper gain stress every round. All right then, so we don't want to hang out in the red stuff, but I mean, we could target this, right? Could I target it? I'm going to throw this on top of this dude so I don't have to deal with him. Bop.
Hey, what's that over there?
And then we'll just kill this guy when he gets here. Yep. Ingrid, step up in the front. Right here. He's coming.
Hi there.
There we go. Oh, there was an extra one. Kind of forgot about that dude. All right. So we just won't stop in that area, right? Is basically it. I would love to stress somebody out. I think I want to stress this guy out if I can. Let's take Alexandrite and let's go ahead and... man, would I love to have an extra AP. Let's use it. One extra AP right here. And I'm going to move her to here. And then I'm going to tether, I think, you to you.
You look nervous.
All right. Then we need to curse that dude. Let's go get our curse on right there. Whoosh. All right. Let's get the gambit.
I fly or I fall.
Perfect. All right. Whispering knife on you. If it hits, would be great. But otherwise, just stress him out. Whop. Perfect. Damage bonus per stress. All right, so there's only two pips left on that guy. And if we arcane burst him now, he won't die. Bop. All right, but he's just going to freak out and then...
You have my attention.
And then attack us.
True. Have you made arrangements?
Attack us in the frenzy that he is. All right, fine. We'll go ahead and take and eliminate this dude. That's for free. Signature charge, reset. And then we can take the Adder's Kiss from here. Oh. Okay, so is she... Do you get the stress just by walking through it? I thought it was ending your turn on it. Hold on, let me do this again. Friends, if I stress on all unbelievers within earshot. So it doesn't necessarily say you have to end your turn there. I am curious. Can I shoot it? Like, what if I shoot these two things? Okay. Okay, well, the frenzied whisper is gone. So that, I mean, shut it up. I guess there's still that. Shoot him.
I'm tired.
All done.
Are we done yet?
All right. It's not that bad. You know, Ingrid took a little bit of, you know, Ingrid got hit a little bit, but otherwise we're fine. She's poisoned. She's going to get cleansed and, you know, I guess we'll just need to find a medical kit. Well, isn't that convenient?
That?
Yes. Oh, we got company.
I have it.
Right back here.
Back into the fray.
Throw right
come
there.
And look.
Before you see me. Got her. I don't know where they are. Oh, it says area clear now. But yeah, area is clear. They're going to find us again.
Hey,
there we go. Okay, so there's a couple guys back in here. Two guys in here. Let's go ahead and grab Gambit real quick. Okay, more stress. Fine. Can you give it to me? Okay. One more try. We'll get it. I don't know what the chances of success are, but we're going to get it. Let's pull you to be right here. It's fine, I guess, for now. We can see him. It's this guy's got the key. This is the guy we need to kill right here. So... can we tether him again? I want to say just maybe is the answer to that question. We'll take the serpent now.
This should do nicely.
Cool. And then we're going to move over here. Right there. Yep. Let's get him tethered. You tethered to you. Boom. Very good. Take the arcane blast there. I already cursed him, right? Pretty sure I did. Ingrid, can you get in there? 80% on the fallen. I'd rather get you in closer. Let's get you in right here. And then if I strike right there, that'll do some damage and stress and all that. I like it.
You break easily.
Let's get you stressed out. No? Did I not curse him yet? Oh my god, I missed the curse. I'm an idiot.
All
right. Get the curse first.
For my own.
All right. Eddie, can we do something about this? Not that. I need you to get you. I'm just going to have you stand right here. This guy can't see you anyway. And as long as we can stress this guy out, it won't be an issue. Bop, bop. All right. So, how's your stress levels? Yeah, are you about ready to pop? I think you are. Pop. All right. There we go. Cool. We dealt with that. Celestine's all that's left. And, I mean, we can finish off or we can just kill. I think we just kill, right? We just take him out. Pop. Done. Very easy. I forgot we had the Phantom. It's been sitting, it didn't follow us when we went around here. So but it's interesting that these guys didn't get like start the combat by seeing the Phantom before. That's a little interesting to me. All right, Ingrid, just gonna go over and finish him off, please. Bop.
All right, good. Improves our position.
It does, doesn't it? I mean, you know, from being under attack to not being under attack. Take the iron key. And now we can get into that door back there. All right. What else? Do we want to go back here? Is it necessary? We can just shoot this thing, right? That's all there is to it. Just shooting it. Yeah. Easy. All right. So we'll just... Oh, the second shot went nowhere. All right, we'll go around it. We should have some other stuff over here. An aura of unease. Some eldritch quality of the air causes hackles to rise and heartbeats to quicken. What's a hackle?
Everything has a use.
I got it. Maybe it's something obvious, but I don't think I've ever heard of a hackle before. A hackle rising. I haven't really spent a whole lot of time like near the sea. You know, I'm not exactly a sailor. So perhaps there's something about being around the... Oh, another iron key. We could have got it from that dude, or we could get it from just right there. Cool. Bigger tonic. Let's give that to... Tell you what, Alexandra has a way of already generating AP. Ingrid doesn't. We're going to give it to you. All right, there we go. Everyone, follow me. And we're going to go around. And I guess we'll try to go through this door. And then our objective, our bonus objective, is right over here. But I also can now get into that building back there, so I kind of want to try that too. I have to remember to do that. Could be something cool over there. There's a second wind. I definitely want to get that. I think... Is that the main objective over there? No. Main objective is behind us. So what's this? If the main objective is behind us...
I'm feeling about this place. Real bad.
Yeah. I'm not sure what to think of this. Because... The main objective is that way. And the side objective is that way. So what the hell is this? Seems cool. Eddie... I mean, is there anyone here? There's obviously a place for reinforcements here. That's a thing. You know, we've got deep stalkers there. More child of the children of the deep, which honestly aren't that big of a deal. That's it though. So like, what is this place? All sorts of stuff going on in here too. Ooh, hey. Interesting. All right, I'm intrigued. Let's explore this area. I was gonna grab the second wind, but I think I'll wait till after this fight to do that. Uh-oh. Everybody get down. Get down. Get down. Get down. Get down. Get down. Celestine. Celestine, no. Celestine. Well, I think it saw us. What is that? So, there's the primeval deep stalkers. These are the ones I'm used to seeing, but this one is like, it's bigger, it's stronger, it's got more facial hair. Got a lot more health. 420 health. Immune to burning. Receives +5 additional shock damage. So it has a shock weakness. Everything is about shocking here. It's immune to takedowns too, probably. Yep. So, like, this is going to be a real challenge. But, right now, I have... Oh? Really? They're alerted? Why? I guess going into turn-based mode, it kicked me out of cover. Is that why? That sucks. All right. Well, how do we want to play this? Probably stressing this guy out if possible, right? So I think what we'll do is the first thing we're going to do is mesmerize this one. Mesmerize the badass one right here. I think that's a good first move.
Go blank. Listen only to me.
We're going
to
take control of him. And now they're going to spread out, and now they're triggered. Weird. So, they weren't activated before? Either way, they also went up by this, which is great for me, too. Eddie's not in cover. I'm not sure it matters with these guys as much, but if I throw the grenade, I want to say that throwing this grenade, it doesn't get both of them. Very sad. I mean, it'll hit this, but it won't get all three. Like, I want to hit both of them with the grenade and then get the explosion. Can't do that. We could do the bullseye. We could do the light 'em up. I think maybe the light 'em up is the best call here. So interesting. What are you shooting for? This game has been patched a few times since I've played too, so there is that. I think before I shoot them, we should get them like tethered up to each other probably too, right? So we'll get the tether. Let's go you here to this one. Get them tethered. Celestine, we're going to curse, but first I'm going to gambit. Come on now. Give me what I want. There we go. Press our luck. No whammies, no whammies, no whammies. Didn't quite get what I wanted. One more time.
Come with me. I am ready.
All right. I think I'm done. I just can't stop. All right. I'm a gambling addict now. Let's hit curse of that one.
I am every horror made real.
All right. With that done, Eddie's light him up. We'll now hit four targets. And we should stress this thing out really quickly because it's going to get hit by the bullet. That's going to put two stress. Then it gets hit by this explosion, which should do two stress as well. So, one, two, three, four.
Run for the heels, boys!
We knocked down our friend. well, hang on. Maybe we... Oh, dear. I don't know what just happened, but we screwed ourselves here. And by ourselves, I mean me. I think I screwed. Yeah, I may have screwed things up. Let's hide. Eddie, I could barrage the whole set. That's one way to do it too, isn't it? Just barrage everything. I have to get closer to do that, and I'm too far away. So I think I'll just go ahead and maybe zoom over here. All right, so Ingrid's up. And Alexandrite. Now, they're immune to fire damage. So, I mean, there's not a whole lot of point in the ghost fire, I don't think. But we could do the warp image on the one that we know is not... Oh, my God. There's already enough warp image going around. Never mind. No more warp image. We could do the frag grenade, but that's not likely to hit a good target. You know, let's just... Target teammate takes 42% less damage for two rounds. You know what? Shield Maiden. Let's do it on Eddie. He's sitting over here with low health, right? I guess it's not really all that low. It's something I can do. We'll just...
Allow me.
He's over there, so... We'll Shield Maiden there. And, Ingrid. Maybe I should have given it to Ingrid, because she can, you know, move and, do things. I don't know about this guy's, like, ranged abilities. Salamander's useless here. I mean, I'm just gonna sit. I think we just build evades. You know? I think I'm just gonna move to here and evade.
There's no time.
I got nothing. I can't hit anything. All right. Now let's see what they do. There's my evade. Perfect. He's slow. Okay. He was our friend. Apparently not anymore. Nope. Apparently not anymore. But we Shield Maiden, so at least there's that. Wow. Okay. Well, we lost the mesmerize. Fun times. How is our stressed out boy doing? Not nearly stressed out enough. Wowzers, this is not going well, is it? If we barrage, we won't hit all of them from this location. We're gonna have to move to hit all of them. And that's no bueno either. Man, oh man, oh man, oh man, I don't like this. Debuff abilities. The target's enemy's next attack will miss. We're going to make sure that this guy's next attack misses this turn.
Come on now. You really think you got a chance?
He will miss, which is good because he's flanking me. And then bullseye on, I guess, on the back guy? On the big guy here. We need to do some damage to this thing.
You did my sights.
79 damage is pretty good. All right. So give me a quick gambit. That's nice. Okay, so I want to try... I want to hit the far one, right? Because they're... I don't even know if they're still... Are you still tethered? It doesn't say there's any active effects. I don't see the tether on him anymore, but I don't know whether or not that's something that actually goes into this list or not. Yeah, that's a bit of an issue there, isn't it? All right, we'll have to move up. Maybe right now is the time to beckon. And then we can always second wind. I was going to second wind Eddie, is what I was trying to do here. But I may not have that choice. Fallen. I can hit the one in the back. Not really. I need to move in here. Ingrid needs to get the hell in here. Let's move her up a little bit. She's apparently wet now. Great. We can try the push kick. Doesn't seem to... It only gives me two targets, which is kind of interesting. I guess that's the farthest I could go. We'll try the... I need to make sure I can move after this, I think, too. Gosh, man. I think it's this target. I'm gonna hit here.
You took your eye off the prize.
All right. So he's blinded. And that was the right one to hit. So I can move now. I got my bonus action to move. And I can move, let's say, right into here. If I stay here, though, then I'll get my free hit when he moves. Maybe that is better. Maybe it's better just to stay put. Give me movement to here. I want to do some work on this guy. He's already cursed, right? Maybe not. Maybe once they do the multiple enemy thing, like, they lose that curse. That would suck. God, there's so much health on that guy. All right. Dynamite is a timed explosive. So, I mean, it's gonna hurt unless I move out of there. So I'm going to take the timed explosive there. And we'll move Ingrid out of the blast. Whispering knife on the big guy.
As the soul rots, so do the flesh.
He's immune to poison damage, but at least getting the damage. And then we can take the warp image and see if we can get everybody to think that he's the enemy.
I only reveal the monster.
There we go. So hopefully they go after him this turn instead of me. And then take the arcane blast. I'm just going to keep piling it on him, I think. Like, really focus him down. We need to remove this guy from the board if possible here. Okay, no more poison. He's moving out. He's still in the blast radius, maybe. I don't know. Yikes, that sucks. Hit him. Yeah, hit him. And stay in the blast radius. Yeah, hit him. He's dead. And that was a forced miss, but he won't miss that one. Okay. This one's still in the blast radius. He's slowing us all down. Stress break, bang. Oh, Eddie's down with a stress break and mortal danger. Oh, man. Oh, we got to help him up. All right. Let's go help him up. We'll stabilize right here at this point.
Most pain is in the mind. Breathe deep.
And then,
I'm back in the saddle. Just about.
He's not going to get a turn. I can help her up to her feet as well. So let's go ahead and do that. She needs to be helped up too. Man, these guys are no joke.
On your feet, darling. I'm fine. Thanks.
All right. We're going to take the extra serpent here. Get that extra AP right now. And we're going to see if we can take that medical kit, use it on our friend.
Don't
there.
Worry. I've read all about this.
Here we go.
My thanks.
Ingrid's
sure
got one AP. And I have Onslaught from here, but I don't know if that's the right target. I think it is, but I don't know that it is. Either way, there's no way I'm going to get around to the point where I'm not flanked. I'm going to be flanked by something. So we're going to see if this is the right target with one. I don't know if the Onslaught's worth it. To be honest, I'd rather see where this guy is and hit him. Should we beckon now? I'm really trying to hold that. Are you guys permanently wet? Or is this a Okay, you're not permanently wet. I thought that was a permanent status for you. So this is a little, that makes it a little bit different, because that means I can ghost fire, you know, over in this side and keep you lit up.
Allow me to open your mind's eye.
There we go. Celestine, I'm gonna take a gamble here. Oh, that's no good, man. All right, I wanted to go over and do the Adder's Kiss, but I think instead what I'm gonna do this time is just build an evade and hope that it shoots at me. Hope that it shoots at Celestine here. We get one Arcane Blast. I'm gonna hit this one, I think. Cast it on that one. I don't think that's the right one. No, it wasn't the right one. Good thing I didn't use Ingrid's special skill on it. We'll take the Fallen and we'll hit. Damn, you know? Don't really have a whole lot of options there for that. We'll try this one.
I'm not here to play games.
So that was the correct one. They're just going to keep slowing us. Now he's wet, immune to fire. And okay. We get the multiplication. Okay. So overall, I think that turn wasn't bad. I figured I was going to start getting pelted, but no, I think we're fine. All right, cool. Both of these guys are in range of this grenade. So I think I'm going to throw this grenade. Be nice to curse that dude and get him all tethered and all that, right? Like, can I get this guy? I mean, they're both pretty low health. I don't really think I can get this guy tethered and stress him out and all that. I don't think we can spend that movement on that. I think we just have to go after him, right? We can take the gambit one time here.
Face my fate.
Very good. Okay, I'm gonna say we curse. I mean, cursing the big guy is probably the best, right?
Torment awaits you.
Because we're not going to be able to stress this guy out enough before we kill him. He's going to die. Let's take the light him up. We're going to go 1, 2.
Light him up!
I only have 2 ammo, so at least I got the one that I've already stressed out more. Curse. Here we go. I think maybe he's there. I think we do this. Hit him.
Y'all may want to start running.
I'll just fire at every single one of y'all. There you go. How you like that? All right. How much stress we got built up there? Not really a whole lot. It's not great on the stressed out bit here. We'll hit him with the dagger. Get some kind of damage there. As he's burning. Very nice. I think... if I stay here, I'm definitely gonna get hit. I'm gonna back up. All right, Alexandrite, we're gonna want to hit. Let's go after. See if we can't get rid of one of these targets. That's the finisher move for you. You can strike here, take that out. There we go. All right, and then the next action could be hitting this guy.
Isn't that a lovely sight?
Add more stress on him. Alexandrite, we're going to pop you. Let's see if we can't get rid of this guy now. If that's possible. One more hit, 11. Ugh. Oh, we crit. That's great. All right, good. I feel much better about this now. All right, so now we just take the one strike here, and that might put you in range for the Overwatch hit to finish you. If honestly, I should have left Celestine there, and then it definitely would have. But if our phantoms can do it, that'd be great too.
Take this.
Yeah. I think the phantom did what it needed to be, like put it over the edge so that could work. Wow, that's crazy. All right, Eddie, first thing, let's go ahead and get your second wind. Beautiful. And we'll inspect this. It says a coral outgrowth. The coral isn't growing on the decks, on the docks, so much as it appears to have been extruded from it. It's growing from the docks, not on the docks. Ah. Anybody need heals? I think we're kind of good. I mean, we have a little bit of healing we could use, but it's not worth a med kit too. I've got two level 2 med kits. It's not worth using that for that little bit of health, so fine. It is interesting to me that reinforcements didn't show up. Like, these pads are right here, and yet no reinforcements came. Blocks of ice still frozen, slick with condensation. The only thing I can think of is that maybe only certain types of units can trigger the alarm for that. And maybe the Squid Games can't do that. I don't know. Ruins from the sea. A slab of limestone with peculiar organic shapes rising from it in bas relief. Peculiarly. I can't speak today at all, man. Should kill these guys, right? I mean, just so we don't accidentally walk into their range and all that. I think we should just pop, pop. There was a second shot there. There we go. The game's a little buggy today. I might try to reload just to see if this it fixes way. Any of it. Let's go ahead and read this lore here. It says, Reflections of Zorana Nicastro IV. Written on water warped paper in a sharp, ardent hand. I stepped into the sea this morning, yearning for metamorphosis, yearning to feel my devouring king's embrace. I cannot surrender myself to the change, not when the power looms so close. And so I refused the sublime bliss of transformation, refused the calls of my mother and Aunt Lucrezia, and so many Nicastros before them. In refusing, I beckoned them to me instead. When they arrived, I fed them tributes, live and squirming. I slid my hand down the muscular tract of my mother's gullet, felt the razored caress of her pharyngeal jaws as they snatched the wriggling morsel from my hand. Their hunger sated, my forebears sank beneath the waves. Hot tears burned my cheeks as I watched them go, my mother and Lucrezia and the rest. When the tower is mine and our devouring king has been reborn, I will shed this body like an old coat. At long last, I will accept my birthright and my family will welcome me home. That is crazy stuff. What do you think the sacrifice was? Was it people or was it something else? I mean, I assume it's people. Well, alive, it said, but I don't know. There's a whole bunch of fish stuff going on here, so.
The Devouring King, in all his dead majesty. Nectar is his blood.
We need to find the extraction tools, and quickly.
All right, so this is where the nectar is. Gotcha. So we don't have the tools yet. We have to go get the tools and then come to this location. Well, at least this fight's done. Cool. The dead god. The smell rising off the thing beneath the pump house is indescribable. Worse than the smell is the feeling that its enormous, cloudy eye may yet blink, or that its multitudinous appendages might lash out in search of flesh. All right, just had a game crash. Had to go back to the last turn of the fight. Finished that up, got the same lore items and stuff that were around. And now we're back in here just so that you guys have continuity and stuff. What's this? The extraction system. Vials, tubes, gears, and valves come together in an intricate mechanism that leads from the thing beneath the pump house to the building's many stills. Ports in the machine's chassis are labeled with basic instructions. Insert extraction tools here. Yeah, so this is the place we're supposed to end up, but we don't have the extraction tools. So that was the main objective that we just skipped over. And like, I guess we're supposed to end up here, which is a very interesting thing that just happened if I think about it, because we didn't get any reinforcements on this fight. And I'm wondering if you don't get reinforcements until, you know, you have to trigger like near the end of the campaign, right? Or near the end of this mission. And so since we've already fought these guys, I have to wonder whether or not we're going to be able to just walk in here and do the thing without any problems later. And maybe we don't even have to deal with reinforcements. Maybe this got a lot easier by doing this fight right now. I just got to think about that.